Hey, what is up guys? My name is Kasmin and in today's video, I'm going to create this mascot design inside the Illustrator. As you can probably tell, I went and saw the Black Panther movie. So after a couple of sketches, I decided on one and I'll bring that inside the Illustrator and get started. I've already placed inside the document the poster on the right. I really like that color scheme and I'd like to follow it in this tutorial. And I've also placed the sketch on the left. Now I've selected it, went to the transparency panel and lowered its opacity so I can trace over it without having any problems, and locked in the selection. I've locked in the selection just to make sure that I won't accidentally move the sketch. But using the pen tool, I'm starting to draw the basic shapes of the head and just follow along the sketch lines. Now this mascot is going to be created out of simple shapes. That's the whole point of a mascot, to have simple and straightforward shapes which can be easily seen even if the logo is very small in size. Once that I've managed to create all of the shapes I wanted, I went to the transparency panel and set the opacity of all the elements to 100%. Some elements are on top of each other, so to rearrange them, I'll be using the keyboard shortcut Command the left bracket. I'll also make the eyes white, let me just do that, and apply the lighter shade of yellow on the nose. This is the part where I start using the Pathfinder tool. I start by making a copy of the main shape of the head and paste it in front. By holding down shift, you can select any element that you'd like to mask and hit the intersect option. I haven't seen a lot of mascots without outlines, and in order to do that, I like going to Object, Path, and use the Offset Path option to create one. Now, the nice thing about this method is that you can have more control and use a specific size. I plan to do a couple more, but before I do that, I've noticed that on the top right corner there's something wrong. And I'll just grab the pen tool and create a shape which I'll merge to the main outline in order to maintain a consistent look. Once that's done, I'll just send the outline shape to the back of the illustration and continue working on the mascot. Right now I'm trying to add more details and give the mascot more dimension using simple shapes. I'll use the pen tool to draw a new pad that cuts the shape behind it in half. Let me switch to outline mode real quick to have a better understanding on the positioning of each anchor point and make small adjustments if necessary. I'll close this shape and, similar to the first part, I'll make a copy of the shape that's behind. Using the intersect tool, I'll match the one I've just created. Once I have the new shape, I can choose a lighter shade of yellow for it, resulting in this nice effect. The type feels a bit flat, and in an effort to apply the same styling as I did to the mascot head, I've duplicated each line of text and I want to give that a different color. I'll use the offset pad option once again, my main goal being to apply a light color only to the top parts that will be left once I intersect these groups of elements and create a nice highlight effect. Let's go to Object, Expand Appearances. Make sure to copy and paste in front the group behind, and once you select both groups, hit Merge. I'll only keep the top parts, and by holding down the Shift key, I can select the remaining ones and remove them. I've also made a couple of changes which were not recorded, but in the end, this is the final look of the Black Panther's logo, which you can download for free, a link should be in the description. Don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it and subscribe for more. As always, I'd be more than happy to answer any questions you might have in the comment section below. Until next time, take care guys,